Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you. So in our previous video we have discussed about the first type of heterotrophic mode of nutrition, that is nothing but what? Saprotrophic mode of nutrition. And in today's lecture we will discuss about the next heterotrophic mode of nutrition, that is what? Parasitic mode of nutrition. Okay, so let's start the parasitic mode of nutrition. So there are the certain non-green plants who doesn't contain the chlorophyll. Okay, for example we can say the cascata or we can say the amarbel. Okay, this is the plant which is a non-green plant. It doesn't contain the chlorophyll. Okay, it basically it is a yellow and it is having the very long thread like twigs. Okay, and it get coiled around the stem or the branches of the leaves. Here in the image you can see the cascata plant or the amarbel plants. Okay, so these are the plants which are a non-green plants, which is yellow in color. Okay, and basically it is non-green plant, that's why it is following the heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Okay, so let's see how they are fulfill the need of the nutrient with the help of the parasitic nutrition. Okay, there are some plants which do not have chlorophyll and that is the reason they are following which mode of nutrition? Heterotrophic mode of nutrition. For example, we can say the cascata plant. Okay, that is what? Yellowish long thread like twigs are there and they get coiled around the stems or the branches. Okay, next one, it takes ready made food from the plant on which it is climbing. Okay, so this cascata or the amarbel plant is get the ready made food. They are taking the ready made nutrition from the plant on which they are climbing. Suppose we can say this is the plant. Okay, so on which it is climbing or on which the twigs of that cascata plant is there, and from this host plant they are sucking or they are taking the nutrients ready made. Okay, and that is the reason they are called as what? Parasite. Okay, so it takes ready made food from the plant on which it is climbing. On the plant on which it is climbing, from that plant only they are taking the nutrients. Okay, the plant on which it climbs is called a host. Okay, and the plant on which this amarbel or cascata plant is climbing, okay, so here we can say it is the mango tree. Okay, so on this mango tree if you can see the twigs of the cascata plant is climbing, then here the mango tree is what? Host tree. From the mango tree they are sucking the nutrients, they are taking the nutrients from this mango tree. Okay, so again, what is meant by the host? The plant on which it climbs, it is called the host. Okay, so the plant on which it climbs and from that plant it is getting the nutrient, ready made nutrient, so that plant is called as what? Host plant. Okay, it takes ready made food from the plant on which it is climbing. The plant on which it climbs is called the host. So from the host plant they are sucking the nutrients, and the same plants they are climbing and sucking the nutrients from that plant, and that plant is called as what? Host plant. Okay, next one, and since they are taking the ready made food, they are taking the ready made nutrients, they are called as what? Parasite. Okay, since it deprives the host of valuable nutrients, cascata is called a parasite. Okay, so since for their nutrition, they are getting from the another plants, okay, from the host plants, they are taking the ready made nutrition, they are doing nothing, only they are absorbing, only they are sucking the nutrients from the host plant, and that is the reason the plants, those who absorbs or sucks the nutrient from the other host plant, that plants are called as what? Parasitic plants. And the cascata is doing the same thing, that's why the cascata is the example of what? Parasitic mode of nutrition, or it is the parasitic plant. Okay, it is a parasite plant. Okay, so let's see the exactly what is the definition of the parasite. The mode of nutrition in which some plants live in or on, very important term, see, the term of nutrition, in which what happens, some plants live in or on, okay, the body of other living organisms and get their ready-made food from them is called parasitic nutrition. Okay, so what is mean by parasitic nutrition? It is a mode of nutrition in which what happened, organisms live in or on the body of other organisms, and from that organism they are sucking the ready-made nutrients as a food, and that type of the nutrition is called as what? Parasitic nutrition. Basically, parasitic means what? Those who are depends on other, those are totally depends on the other for the food. Okay, they can't do anything for their food, they are totally depends on other. Okay, so the mode of nutrition in which plants live, some are living inside or some are living on also. Okay, so animals are living inside the body of human being. We can say the different types of the worm, flatworm, tapeworms, okay, they are living in our body. Some are the feeding on our body. For example, we can say the leech is feeding on our body. Okay, so some are living in or on of the on the body of other living organism. For what? To get their ready-made food from them, and that type of the nutrition is called as what? Parasitic nutrition. And the organism, those who are following the parasitic mode of nutrition, they are called as what? Parasite. Okay, they are called as what? Parasite. Okay, so the parasitic mode of nutrition, or there are the two types of the parasite animals. Some are totally parasite and some are partial parasite. Okay, so the total parasite, from the name only we can understand that what is meant by total parasite means for their food they are totally depends on the host plant. They are doing nothing, just sucking the nutrients from the host plant, and that parasites are called as what? Total parasite. Example is our cuscuta. Okay, another one mode, another method is there, another one type of the parasite is there, that is what? Partial parasite. Now partial means what? Little bit. Okay, they are literally depends on the other for the less amount, they are depends on other for their food. For example, we can say the mistletoe. Okay, mistletoe is the example of the partial parasite. Okay, so partial parasite means what? This mistletoe is a green in the color. Okay, they can make their own food, but to make that food, the water and the minerals they are sucking from the other plant. Okay, means something they are doing and some things they are taking from other, that's why they are what? Partial parasites. Okay, so they are taking, they are green in color, they can do the photosynthesis process, but to take that photosynthesis process, they are absorbing the water and minerals from the other plants, and that is the reason they are what? Partial parasite. And the example is what? Mistletoe. Okay, so this is all about the parasitic nutrition, and the organisms, those who are showing the parasitic nutrition, are called as what? Parasite. Here we have discussed the one example, that is cuscuta. Also we have discussed about the total parasite and the partial parasite. Okay, so this is all about today. We will meet in the next video. This is the time to tell you goodbye. Till then, thank you.